I think for me, my moment of figuring out that there has to be a better way was when I became a mother. I had absolutely no interest in education till then. I'd had, of course, a very conventional upbringing, I mean, schooling, but I had the best time in a design college when I did my graduation. And I then realized what it means to be listened to, what it means to be noticed, what it means to have a voice, and how do the adults in your environment support that, you know? And I thought that was, for me, the first awakening. Subsequently, I did my design firm, understood the whole idea of user-centeredness as a way to make experiences better. And then I became a mom. And when my son went to school, I think I realized how easily and how insidiously the child becomes incidental to the learning program. So all of 6 years, I saw my son not have a voice. I saw my son just, you know, being rewarded for compliance over conversation. And I said, there has to be a better way. So I think as a mother, I reacted, but as a designer, I responded, took the opportunity to say, let's do something. So pretty much didn't really set out to change education because I don't think that was the enormity of this endeavor, was not something that I took on to myself. It was just my child's life. I mean, there has to be a better way. So I actually started the school in my home, and then that's been now 20 years.